All right, you know, we talked to officials in Okeechobee County, and just like officials there, experts today say septic tanks are to blame for those algae blooms. And the expert tells us that the county needs to update its infrastructure to help combat the problem.
Algae blooms. They seem to be popping up on the Treasure Coast more and more each day. Dr. Brian LaPointe appeared before St. Lucie County Commissioners Tuesday morning to discuss the issue. The research professor from FAU's Harbor Branch has conducted long-term research in the St. Lucie estuary and the impacts of urban runoff. He says his research points to nutrient pollution and fecal contamination as the major causes of those algae blooms.
Many have thought that this is coming from Lake Okeechobee. It's not. It's coming right out of people's backyards from septic tanks that are contaminating the groundwater that's flowing into the estuary.
LaPointe says when it rains, the nitrogen and other matter from the septic systems head straight to the local waterways.
And once that algae is in the canals around these septic tanks, that nitrogen is feeding those blooms and allowing it to build up that kind of guacamole-like sludge that we saw several years ago.
He says the septic tanks along the St. Lucie River need to be hooked up to a centralized collection system, and that would help reduce the nitrogen that's coming from those septic tanks.
A septic tank nitrogen is somewhere between 40 to 60% of the total nitrogen. And guess what? 900 people a day are moving to Florida. 40% of them are going on septic tanks.
And he says he believes the algae issue is a wake-up call for all utilities around the state to tighten up their infrastructure and to push the septic to sewer program. Live in the newsroom, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News.